Hello and welcome back to Engineering Online. This is the last tutorial of Arduino series for beginners. There are different kinds of sensors in the market and their integration with Arduino is quite interesting, especially when the desired output is achieved and we can easily manipulate it. We have so many sensors like temperature monitoring sensor, heart pulse rate sensor, soil moisture detection sensor, etc. In this video, we are going to learn about the interfacing of Arduino Uno with IR obstacle detection module. As the name suggests, it detects any obstacle or object coming in the path of sensor. Let's see how it can be done, but first we have to learn the basics of IR communication. IR is an infrared radiation and it cannot be seen by human eye. In electromagnetic spectrum, infrared band corresponds to 430 terahertz to 300 gigahertz and it has a wavelength of 980 nanometers. The propagation of light waves in this band can be used for a communication system of data. They are perfect for wireless communication. This communication can be between two portable devices or between a portable device and a fixed device. IR communication is quite easy, inexpensive and most commonly used. It has several advantages, that is, it is secure and highly directional. Plus, they are not harmful for human beings, that is why they can be used at any place. The data rate of infrared communication is about 1 gigabits per second and it can be used for sending information like video signals, etc. First, let's have a brief introduction of this IR module. This is a multi-purpose infrared sensor and it can be used for obstacle sensing, color detection, fire detection, line sensing, etc. The sensor generates an easy-to-use digital output, either high or low. The sensor outputs a logic 1 when an object is placed in front of the sensor and a logic 0 when there is no object in front of the sensor. This digital output can be directly connected to an Arduino, Raspberry Pi, AVR, PIC or any other microcontroller to read the sensor output. Its input voltage lies in the range of 3.3 to 5 volts and that is why it can be powered using Arduino 5 volt pin directly. The sensor has a hole of 3 mm diameter, that is why it can easily be mounted at any surface. It is mainly used for sensing IR remote signals and wireless communication. Now let's explore all the components of IR module. First of all, there is an IR emitter LED and it looks same as other normal LEDs. It emits IR radiations. These radiations are received back by the black colored IR receiver. Then there are three main connection pins. First one is VCC. The module would be supplied with power using this pin. Most commonly, it is powered through Arduino board. Then second pin is ground pin. It is directly connected to the ground pin of Arduino. Then we have out pin. This port in the sensor sends a digital output to the Arduino board. It can send two signals, either high or low. Output goes low whenever there is an obstacle in front of the sensor, else it remains high. You can see a blue colored potentiometer on the module. It is used to adjust the detection distance. The detection distance decreases if it is rotated in counterclockwise direction and the distance increases if it is rotated in clockwise direction. We have two LEDs on this module. First one is obstacle LED. This LED is illuminated when there is an obstacle in front of the module. And the second one is power LED. This power LED is illuminated when the module is powered up. All the major components of this module have been discussed briefly. Now let's move towards it interfacing with Arduino board. Only three connections are required between IR object detection module and Arduino board. First of all, connect the VCC pin of module with the 5 volt pin of Arduino. Now connect the ground pin of module with the ground pin of Arduino. And in the end, connect the Vout pin of module with the digital pin 7 of Arduino Uno. Connections are quite simple. Now let's do the same connections on the hardware also. Once the wiring is completed, let's write the software code on Arduino IDE. Since we know that the interfacing of Arduino and IR object detection module is quite easy, and all we have to do is to detect the changes in the out pin of module. So whenever the pin goes low, that means there is an obstacle in front of it. In this regard, I will initialize some variables here. There is an onboard LED on Arduino at pin 13. I will initialize it. Then we take out pin of module that is connected to pin 7 of Arduino. And another variable is initialized as high, that means there is no obstacle in front of it. Once all the initializations are completed, let's get to the configuration part of program inside the setup. First of all, set the module of LED as an mode of LED as an output and is obstacle pin to input for Arduino. Our second task is to set the baud rate of Arduino IDE serial monitor, and we do this by invoking serial.begin function. Now let's get to the actual program inside the loop. Digital read command is used to read the value of pin 7. The value would be saved in the variable is obstacle. If the value of pin 7 equals to low, that means if condition would be true, and the string obstacle would be printed on the serial monitor using serial.println command, and the LED on the Arduino would become high also. In case if the value of pin 7 is high, that means no obstacle, so the string clear would be printed on the serial monitor and LED on board would become low. The loop would be continued in this way with a small delay. The coding is almost completed. We will compile this program and upload it on Arduino board. Open the serial monitor and enjoy the interfacing of Arduino Uno and IR object detection module. That was enough for today. Thank you so much for watching. That was the last tutorial of Arduino series for beginners. We have tried our best to introduce Arduino and its interfacing with the most commonly used electronic components in quite easiest way. Do try it on your own and give your valuable feedback in the comment section. Plus, if there is any confusion or query, feel free to ask. Do like this video and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming projects and series. Thank you.